In this illustration, we'll discuss the calculation of a tower height. We are given that a stone falling from the top of a vertical tower has descended x meter, when another is let to fall from a point y meter below the top. If they fall from rest and reach ground together, we are required to find the height of the tower in this situation. Here, if we draw the picture, say this is a tower of height h, and a stone 1 is dropped from the top, and when it will descend by a distance x meter, then obviously the time taken in descending x meter we can write as root 2x by g. And then another stone is dropped, obviously at this point it will attain some speed, and another stone 2 is dropped from a height or a depth y meter below the top, and we are given that this stone 1 and 2 will reach the bottom of ground, the bottom of this tower together, the ground together. So in this situation we can say total time in which stone 1 hits the ground is, this total time for the stone 1 and hitting the ground is root 2h by g, because it is freely falling from rest by height h. This height h we can write separately. And out of this time, root 2x by g is gone when 2 is dropped. So we can write time available for stone 2 in reaching ground is, this time can be written as t2, and is root of twice of h minus y by g. And this time we can equate with the root 2h by g minus root of 2x by g, because out of this root 2x by g this much time is gone, and the remaining time is the time taken by stone 2 in reaching ground, and it has to fall in free fall from rest a height h minus y. Now if we simplify this, here g gets cancelled out, and on simplifying this expression we can write it as 2h minus root of twice of h minus y is equals to root 2x. If we square this relation, this will give us 2h plus 2h minus 2y minus of 4 times root of h multiplied by h minus y is equals to 2x. And in this situation, if we further square this term here, you can see on left hand side we can write 2 times root of h square minus hy, which is equals to this 2h minus x plus y. I have cancelled the value of 2, numerical value 2. And if we further square it, you can see this will give us 4h square minus 4hy is equals to 4h square plus x plus y whole square minus 4hx minus 4hy. Here 4h square and 4hy both gets cancelled out, and if we continue over here, this will directly give us the value of h, which is x plus y whole square by 4x. That is the final result of this problem.